So these are the seven things. Before we review them again, you know, as he says, if a person knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to be upon the Tawheed, you know, the Tawheed comes from Wahid, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. And therefore, we worship him alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in one path. Like Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, he put it in a very beautiful statement in his poetry, فَلِوَاحِدٍ كُنْ وَاحِدًا فِي وَاحِدٍ أَعْنِي سَبِيلَ حَقِّ وَلِمَنْ. That means, to one, be one in one. This is how our deen is. It's about the Tawheed. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be one. Don't be too many things in your heart. You're only seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone in one path, which is the path of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. That's why kalimatu al-tawheed, la ilaha illallah Muhammadu Rasulullah. The first one is the tawheed of al-ibad. The one that is to be worshipped is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Muhammadu Rasulullah, the one to be followed, is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is the covenant of al-iman, that means in the hearts of the believer, the only one that he wants to follow in the absolute sense is the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is why we ask the people of knowledge and so on. Even if there's differences of opinions, but in the heart of every Muslim, this is to the best of my ability, this is what I know is the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to have, to be upon the Tawheed. And what negates the Tawheed is a shirk, associating partners with Allah. And we have to know the good deed and what negates it, what breaks it. If you know how to make salah, but you don't know what breaks the salah, you might break your salah without knowing. So the tawheed, what negates it, is a shirk, associating partners with Allah. This is knowledge to be taught and for us to learn. And also, if a person knows that Allah ahalla al-bay'a wa harrama al-riba, if Allah permitted buying and selling and he forbade riba, or he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade to take the wealth of the orphan, حَرَّمَ أَكْلِ مَالِ يَتِيمٍ, as it's mentioned in Surah An-Nisa and others. وَأَحَلَّ لِوَلِيهِ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, and he permitted for the wali of the yatim, the guardian of the orphan, he can use the money with ma'roof, with goodness. Like, it becomes very difficult if the guardian of the orphan is taken from the money of the orphan to spend on the orphan. So it's very difficult to make sure that every penny is spent on the orphan. For example, if he brings food to the orphan and they're living together, then it's okay to eat from it. This is basically what is meant. If a person is rich, mashallah, this is good. But there is a job to be given to the guardian of the orphan if he's an orphan. So these are rulings for people to observe. But if he is in that situation, especially with that specific example, وَاجَبَ عَلَيْهِ أَنْ يَعْلَمَ الْمَأْمُورَ بِهِ وَيَسْأَلْ عَنْهُ إِلَىٰ أَنْ يَعْرِفُ. He has to have the knowledge of what he's been commanded to do and to ask the people of knowledge of what is permissible and what's not permissible for him. And he knows what's haram when it comes to this. And he keeps on asking about it till he gets to know it. So this is how the believers, they exalt the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the commands of Allah. And then when you go to this issue of the tawheed versus the shirk, then when we look at the reality of people, or many Muslims or so, you would find that they know, of course, that the tawheed is haq and the shirk is batil, is falsehood. But many people might turn away from knowing what is a tawheed. And they don't have that concern towards what is a tawheed. What is a tawheed? We have to learn it. Right? We have to learn what is a tawheed. It's not just something that, or some idea that we have in our hearts or so about the tawheed. We have to learn what it is. What is the tawheed? And they say, oh, so and so, help me, right? I'm applying for a job, please help me. Isn't that a reality that we have in the Muslim world? This is called shirk. This is not just called something else. Al-wasila, or the mean to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has to be a valid mean, according to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone with his names and attributes, asking Allah with your good deeds, asking someone alive to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you, there's no problem. But other than that, asking someone that does not, this is not that his responsibility, or this is what he's for. So we get to know that from the wahi, from the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to ask about this and to be upon this, people hang tamimas and stuff, you know, the amulets, or they put it around their arms. Why do they do these types of things? Whether it has it in it Quran or sometimes or many times, it's all jinn stuff, right? Marks and signs that if you open it, you don't understand what's in there. Why? Because they've been deceived by those who make wal'iyadhu billah sihr or something like this. And they deal with the jinn. To protect them from the jinn, they have to make a deal with the jinn, worshipping other than Allah. And it's even if it's only Quran. Why a person would hang something on him like this for protection? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the protector. This is not a security camera that you put in your home. It's okay to do that. It's a physical mean, right? So you have to have either a physical mean as means of protection, and at the same time, the religious means has to be based on clear evidence in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And because of ignorance, you would find these types of things maybe present in the lives of people. Even to the extent of which of how to purify our hearts from this. The Prophet ﷺ, when he warned this ummah from shirk al-khafi, from the hidden shirk. Hidden, that means you won't feel it. Because it's more hidden than the footsteps of an ant on a rock. You don't hear that. You won't feel it. You have to have the knowledge of it and work on yourself to eliminate it. What is the shirk al-khafi? Abdullah ibn Abbas, the nephew, the cousin of the Prophet ﷺ, the one that the Prophet ﷺ made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma alimhu al-ta'wil wa faqihu fi al-deen. Allah, make him comprehend and understand the ta'wil of the Qur'an, the tafsir of the Qur'an, and make him comprehend the knowledge of the religion. He used to say, what is the hidden shirk? Anybody remember? We said it a couple of days ago. He mentioned an example. When a person says, لَوْلَا الْبَطُّ فِي الدَّارِ لَسُرِقَ الدَّارِ. When someone says, if it wasn't for the ducks in the house, the thief would have stolen it. Because he has ducks. So when the thief came, the ducks made noise, so the thief ran away. So this is a hidden shirk. Why? Because who's the one that protected his house from being stolen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ducks, yes, made a noise and the guy ran away. You can say the ducks made noise and you can even bring ducks, and actually this is not legal in the city, right? So you can, people bring dogs, for example, and it's not permissible to have a dog inside of the house. But if they have a dog in the yard, because they're an area where they want to, for security reason, right? They're bringing it for security reason. This is halal. There's nothing wrong with that. But if the dog was a reason for, you saw signs that somebody was trying to steal and the dog got him and so on, don't say, if it wasn't for the dog, my house would have been stolen. Don't say that. But rather say, Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected my house. And the dog was a mean. He's a mean. The dog is a mean. The dog is not the protector. So it's a very slight, very light thing, but it shows that the heart should not be attached to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same thing when people would say, flying, and the captain was such a great one that he made it. Right? This is, the words is not appropriate. It's bad manners with Allah. You can still say that he's a great person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved us. And the captain was great. You have to refer things to what it is really. Right? Like, and we learn this from the Quran. Look at what the prophets, they say, they always refer everything good to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, he could have made that guy become intoxicated, or he's not able to do things, or paralyzed all of a sudden, or the dog is dying, you know, all kinds of things can happen. Everything is by the will of Allah. While the means is there, yes, and we take the means, but the hearts are only attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a matter of ilm. And if a person knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade riba, وَبَاعَ وَاشْتَرَ وَلَمْ يَسْأَلْ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade riba, and that person buys and sells and he did not ask about the riba. That means he did not take these steps that he's supposed to take when it comes to the commands of Allah. You read in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade riba. And then you seek rewards from Allah by reciting, and every hasana is 10, every letter is 10 rewards, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. And you take the blessings of the ayat, and we hear it in Salatul Taraweeh, and we meet the khatma of the Quran more than one time. But then after we finish the salah, we go sign the contracts. And whether even with good intentions or bad intentions, but without knowing, without asking, is that riba? What is the meaning of riba? What is the types of riba? You don't want to learn, that's fine. You don't have to learn the details of it. It's a very detailed subject. But at least, as the people of knowledge, those you trust the knowledge in the religion, so that you become practicing what you learn when you what you learn and what you read and so on. And if he knows that Allah forbid to take the wealth of the orphan, and then he turned away and he didn't ask, not that he took and stole, no, he did not even ask how to deal with these types of things. This is mandatory for us to do. So to love what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so this is when it comes to the knowledge of things.